Have you ever had a great idea for an invention, just like, why hasn't anyone thought of this yet, and then you go online and see that it exists? Well, I present to you the Chargeplay Clutch, one such invention that I've always wanted, and now it exists. So yes, hey guys, Anthony here, and welcome to a kind of sponsored video, but not really. I'm not getting paid to talk about this thing. They just said, hey, we're gonna send you out a Chargeplay clutch from HyperX. If you wanna check it out and make a video, go for it and put it out, and, you know, whatever. And I was like, all right, cool. And the reason the Chargeplay caught my eye is because I'm a big fan of, you know, here's the unit right here, but I'm a big fan of controllers that you, you know, separate and you can put your phone in and just play, that give you a little bit more control over your phone and just make it a little more comfortable. In the past, I've looked at other controller grip things, and one thing I always had in my head was, why don't they put a wireless charger on these things so you can just plug it in and have it wirelessly charge your phone and not have to worry about, you know, if you put a phone into the controller and you have a wire coming out the side, it gets in the way of your hand all the time. Well, damn it, HyperX did it, because in my email they sent me this and they said, hey, we have a controller grip with a wireless charger built in, and not only a wireless charger built in, but a battery pack that goes onto it that charges your phone while you play. So yes, this is the HyperX Chargeplay Clutch, and it's a simple controller grip. You know, it's just normal plastic, it's fairly rigid, but once you put the phone into it, then it feels really solid in the hands. But if you think about this versus, you know, a controller, and versus like a Nintendo Switch, it's not that big. It's thicker, that's for sure, but it's not that unwieldy to put in a backpack and just take with you somewhere. As far as the feeling of the device, I really like how big the controller grips are. One, it just feels good in the hand, it's very comfortable, but two, a lot of times I like to play games on my phone laying down and have it above my head. And when it's above your head and these are thick enough, you're not just having it rest against your hand, you're actually holding it up using the thickness of the controller grips. So because of that, it's so much more comfortable and you have so much more control. Now that being said, some younger gamers with smaller hands, or just adults with smaller hands, might find it to be a little more unwieldy. It might be like the Duke, the original Xbox controller. And it also depends a bit on the phone you're putting in there. If you put in the Galaxy Note 9, which I have, I noticeably have an issue reaching the center of the screen. But if you use a more reasonable phone, like a Galaxy S8, then you can totally reach, no problems. And then actually, it looks kind of funny now with the tiny phone in there. With the big phone in there, it looks like it belongs. Now it's huge. But yeah, I'm a big fan of just having the controller grips anywhere you go, anywhere you get to play, having something much more comfortable that feels much more like a traditional controller, because I'm more of a traditional gamer. I appreciate that. Now to talk about the biggest feature of the Chargeplay is, well, the charging. Without even talking about the battery pack, this piece alone has a wireless charger built into it, and they smartly included a power port on top. You can just plug this in, and it will charge your phone while you're playing, eliminating that wire that sticks out the side. You know, when you have a wire just coming out the side over here. They have openings for that if you need to, but it's so much more uncomfortable to have this kind of setting. So to just be able to put this on and let it wirelessly charge it through the back is already a great feature, and then it gets better. Next, we have the battery pack, which has its own little button on it. You know, you can see an indicator. It's basically a power bank, like any other power bank, but it's specifically designed to snap onto the back of this. There you go, and it's on there pretty tight. You know, it's definitely a nice solid feel. And on this battery pack, there's also a charger. So you could have this on and then plug that in as well and let it play. But what I also love is that this piece alone can be wirelessly charged. It's like HyperX thought of everything, and I'm not getting paid to say this, I'm not a shill, but they really did think through this product well, because even this device can be wirelessly charged. What I find funny is, check this out. If you have the device, you plug it in, you can actually wirelessly charge the battery pack on top of itself, because this can be wirelessly charged. Everything is wirelessly charged. Inside this battery is a 3000 milliamp hour battery, which is basically another phone. I have the Galaxy Note 9, so it's basically the same amount of charging, give or take a few milliamps. So that's basically giving you double the battery life. And imagine if you get your hand on a few of these, you could just keep swapping them in and out and play forever. Now, right now, I don't see anything that says they're selling these separately, but I would imagine they would at some point. But with the way phones work, phones have their own power built into them. So this thing you put this on, you charge your phone. If you empty this, you can go put this on a charger somewhere, let it go charge, keep playing while the phone runs on its own battery, and this will charge easily in the amount of time that your phone is going to be using its battery to play the game. So really, as long as you have somewhere to charge every, you know, cycle or whatever, you should be fine. I did want to say this controller grip has plenty of room for things with cases. In the past, I've had to take my case off to put it into controllers. This one's just designed for bigger phones or more modern phones, because phones just keep getting bigger and bigger and bigger. You know, this used to be the standard phone, and now it looks like a miniature phone. It's pretty funny. Also, because this grip uses wireless charging and it's designed for gaming, it could increase the heat output of your phone significantly. I mean, wireless charging works by heating up this surface and heating up the bottom of your phone, transferring power. So if you're gaming while also wirelessly charging, it can make your phone pretty warm. I mean, nowadays, they're pretty good at throttling themselves and keeping, you know, temperatures within gauge, but you might find, I'd have to do some testing and more in-depth benchmarks to see if there's any degradation in gaming performance, but it wasn't noticeable when using it for, you know, hours in any appreciable way, so I wouldn't really be too concerned with that, unless you're super concerned about the temperature of your phone or your phone's made of wood or something. I don't know. It's a weird world out there. Another thing I was surprised with how thick this is that it doesn't quite work as a stand. Even though it's so big, you can't stand it up to be used in this position and then maybe a controller, which some other ones have. So in the future, you know, a battery pack with a little fold-out part that just comes down, or maybe just a part that pushes down and snaps into place to allow the phone to then stand upright, could be cool, but it's not really designed for, you know, using it like a Nintendo Switch with another controller. It's designed to be its own contained mobile gaming experience. And you know what? It works pretty well for that. So I want to say thank you to HyperX for sending me this. It was really fun to just take a look at it. You know, this is a really well thought out product. There's no like glaring flaws to it. They made a controller, you put your phone in, it wirelessly charges it, and I can see myself bringing this with me now instead of a, you know, a Nintendo Switch. Sometimes I don't have a Switch Lite, I have an original Switch, and sometimes that's too big. I could see putting this in the bottom of my bag. It doesn't have a screen. I'm not too concerned with it getting damaged because it's fairly solid, and I can just chuck it in my bag, pull it out, play a quick game on a plane or something if I want to, and then put it away. And these kind of things can be great for emulators as well. I have my Dreamcast on there all the time, just playing old classics that I love, and it makes it much more comfortable, much more enjoyable. You can have so many games on your phone, and this thing just helps you play them.
Right there's Big the Cat. Look at that son of a bitch.
Price-wise, it's coming out at $59.99, so $60 for this controller, but considering the amount of tech you get in here, a battery bank, you know, can easily be, you know, $20. The controller grips could be easily 30-something bucks, and all the wireless technology put in there with another charger, I think that equals out to a fair amount of tech for the price that you're getting. So thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know if this is something you're into. I know a lot of people on this channel aren't really into mobile gaming. Some people are. It's a bit of a split community, and I like to take normal gamer, I call them normal gamers, you know what I mean, traditional gamers, and say, hey, you can also have fun on your phone, and there's ways that it can be helped and, you know, make it more enjoyable. So thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know what you think about the HyperX. I'm gonna go play some more Crazy Taxi or Dreamcast. I'll see you later.